telling the new world order to go straight to hell. You're listening to the ABS show on rockandroll100fm.com.
Okay, this is my latest podcast. I have been very, very upset the past few days, as a lot of people. One can say I wasn't there, so I shouldn't be as affected as I am. But anybody who looks at my YouTube channels knows I go to quite a lot of concerts. And I'm thinking, what if I'd been at this concert? What if my mother and my sister had been at this concert? For the past few years, especially since ISIS made their announcement that they would be attacking concert venues in the Paris attack with the Eagles of Death Metal band, I've had a very hard trouble going to concerts. And now it's going to be even worse. I don't even want to go to concerts anymore at all. And I almost come to that conclusion anyway because of that scare that my sister and my mother had with the Riverbend Festival. And they went to see Toby Keith, another country artist, one who played for the President of the United States, Donald Trump, the 45th President. I have this feeling that Antifa is cohorting with ISIS to attack conservatives and Christians and concert goers of country music artists. That's just my opinion. And I think when this info comes out about this current douchebag who shot up all these innocent people and killed them and injured a lot of them, I think he was working for someone. They can throw up all they want to about being lone wolf and this and that. I don't believe that is a conspiracy theory. There is no way in hell he was a lone wolf. It's too big. And if he was, he sure was a destructive one. I agree with Hagman and Hagman. I agree with Doug Hagman. I don't think we should be rushing to narratives and conclusions. And yes, my coverage mostly did. I kept saying, I'm wondering if he's hollering Allah Akbar and all this other stuff. But you know something? Normally that's what it is. And normally the media covers it up. And that was the whole reason I was doing my coverage that night. Because it wasn't because I was trying to be first or any of that. I wanted to discuss the things that most people will not discuss. They will not discuss that there's a problem with Islamic terror in this country. They don't want to face it. They want to pretend like Islam is not a threat. Well, Islam is a threat. And I still think that he was working for somebody. I don't know if it was Antifa. I don't know if it was some other radical leftist group. I don't know if it was ISIS. They claimed responsibility for him. According to InfoWars, they even had him as a name. a name, a Muslim name. Alex Jones talked to the several people that went in on him, went in the room. Those were his sources. Doug Hadman said the other night that he had some sources telling him some things, but he wasn't going to elaborate. And I haven't had a chance to listen to the current Doug Hadman show. I had to turn off Savage tonight. I'm not going to get mad at him or anything, because he's just having the post-traumatic stress disorder. The rest of us is suffering from this. It's horrible. I've cried. I've gotten mad. Just like Jason Aldean. And, you know, I never did like, because I don't like that new country. The newest country acts that I liked was Big and Rich, and it was only because I liked Lone Star. I don't really accept this new country that well. But now I've gained a new respect for that man, because he's went through a lot. He's went through hell. His fans have went through hell. His mental health is destroyed right now. Just like mine probably will be, because I'm not going to any more concerts. If I don't have plans to go to it, I'm not going to it. And they will be no more in the foreseeable future while we live in this new hellhole, this new world that we live in, this garbage, evil, vile, sick. You'd think we'd all be Americans here, but not this scumbag, not these scumbags in the streets attacking Trump supporters. You know, I hated Barack Obama, but all I did was went on YouTube and make videos bashing him. That's all I did. That's how I do every president that I don't like. I bash George Bush. When I found out what George Bush was on my Anthony Phillips Stone website years ago, and I wished I had a screenshot of it, I put 666s on his and Dick Cheney's head. And that Karl Rove. And I put their heads on my website. But that's what I do. I just ridicule them, call them clowns, evil people, vile people. If they're New World Order, I'll speak out against them. But I don't go hurt them. I don't go plot to hurt liberals. I don't plot to even hurt the New World Order. Now, these New World Order people would probably deserve it if they ever pushed us to that point of view. But that's another question. And if I was ever faced with the self-defense card, and I'd have to defend myself against one of these animals, I would. I would fight back. But it's the point that we are supposed to be Americans. It don't matter if we're black. It don't matter if we're white. It don't matter if we're Mexicans. It don't matter if we're Asians. It don't matter if we're Puerto Ricans. Yes, I named Puerto Rico because they're saying Trump's mistreating them. That woman's just... She's riding the Democratic coattails, is what she's doing. I don't believe that crap, because Trump was real good to the America, to Texas and Florida. Puerto Rico's kind of, even though it's a territory, they're still their own government. And there's a lot of stuff about what they're doing and about them rejecting the stuff down there. It don't matter if we're even Muslim Americans, the ones that come here and want to assimilate and want to become American citizens and loves this country just like the rest of us. It don't matter what we are. The only people I shun out is the non-American citizens who come here and steal identities and stealing jobs and all that. But I'm still not going to hurt them people. You know what I'm saying? I have never hit one Mexican here in this town. In the 25, 30 years I've lived with them, I've never hurt one of them. I may have called them names and I may have told them to go back home, but I've never hurt one of them. I've never went up and physically attacked them. I don't even wish harm on them. You know that? I don't even really wish harm on them. But these animals, they want us dead. And he was a liberal. He attacked a concert that he knew that there was going to be conservative people at, Christians. And I don't know if he was a lone wolf, and I doubt it. I doubt he's the lone wolf. But I got off the Savage subject. He done it before. I had to turn him off once before. Everybody, and I know he don't care. He don't care what we think. He's an opinionated person, and he has his own opinions, and he has his own views. I'm not even really mad at him. But he started in about putting TSA in hotels. Now, when we start giving up our rights to gain security, we get neither. And I'm not no John Wayne, and I'm not no whatever you call that. And I might be, yes, I might be a homegrown disabled journalist that don't have a job. I'm disabled. I might be a homegrown journalist, one of them people he throws off on in the nightshirts, as he calls them. But I don't normally say bad things about Savage. I'm not even saying bad things about him here or there. But I did turn it off because I do not want TSA. Indeed, trips will be off limits too with me if that starts. I won't go to a damn hotel there's TSA agents in. I don't want to be faced with them. I don't fly, so I don't have to put up with the TSA agents except for the few shows that I've seen that they've been at. And I have a feeling they'll be at all of them now. But the difference is that no TSA agent, no security guard, no police officers, no anything could have stopped this. No gun control. Because if he's working with people like I think he is, if he's linked to terrorism like I think he is, and he may not have no contacts, but his girlfriend was traveling in and out of the country, as InfoWars pointed out yesterday. They even had an article about how Antifa is going over there and training with Kurdish terrorists and Syrians in Syria and ISIS. So I think this man's connected to something. He's connected to some kind of terrorism. I don't know if he's a lone terrorist. But I doubt it. I don't believe this conspiracy theory about him being a lone wolf. Just because he don't have Facebook, he was smart. This was a smart cookie. He thought of everything. He covered his trails. I don't know why he covered his trails. I guess he wanted to pull it off. He got out of this exactly what he wanted. But I'm not going to concerts anymore. I'm not going to any kind of thing where I have to be in a crowd. If I went to church, I'd stop going to church right now. Because you know that they're going to eventually start attacking churches. You can worship God anywhere. I can worship God where I stand. I don't need a church for that. Some people do. I don't. I'm not gathering anywhere where there's crowds. I'm going to try to avoid crowds. Yes, I'm already reclusive anyway. I've been reclusive since I had my disability and before I had my disability. I basically become a recluse the day I got out of school. I don't really care. And I don't care what people think of me. You can think what you want to think. But I did have one joy in life, and these scoundrel scumbums and skanks have taken that away from me. These animals. I'm not going to attend concerts anymore. I'm going to miss it. I'm going to miss it very bad. But thank God I got to see Guns N' Roses. And thank God I got to see Motley Crue. And thank God I got to see Marilyn Manson. And thank God I got to see everybody that I've got to see. Def Leppard, Kiss, people I grew up with. I didn't get to see Tom Petty. He was too expensive when he came to down there close to Atlanta. He came to that rich part of Atlanta down there, one of them rich cities, and he was charging high tickets that time he was here in my vicinity, and I haven't checked since then. I didn't get to see Tom Petty. I loved Tom Petty's music. I grew up on him. I was sad. I even made a video yesterday when they early announced he wasn't even dead when they made that announcement. They didn't announce him dead at 8 p.m. But he was already brain dead. I grew up listening to Tom Petty, never got to see him. I used to like Bruce Springsteen. Bruce Springsteen has become a political hack. So has Pearl Jam, and I won't go see them. But I loved them as children. Pearl Jam was one of my main vocal influences. Eddie Vedder. But I won't go see them because of their political stances. But at the same time, I wouldn't wish any harm on Eddie Vedder. I wouldn't wish any harm on Pearl Jam. I wouldn't wish harm on Pearl Jam's fans. That's how demented these people are. I don't even wish harm on somebody I despise, like Jay-Z. I despise Jay-Z. He's an animal. He's a New World Order smut, scumbum, scoundrel, devil. And I wouldn't even wish harm on him. I'd put him in prison. Him and his Obama. As conspirators to destroy this world. But I wouldn't kill him or anything, or I wouldn't hurt him. These animals don't have no respect for human life. They go around about turning the stuff about Christians about not loving, but if you loved people, you wouldn't hurt them. I don't care what your excuse is. You go on about love, why don't you love? Hypocrite. Have a fit about somebody's few words they say about people. Or a name, or a word, or a flag. And you're going around killing people. You even brag about it and laugh about it. Disgusting. Disgusting. So I'm not going to listen to Savage for a while again. I'll eventually get over it. I got over it the last time I got mad at him about something. It was just one of these other terror attacks, and he started in about the gun control. And he was going on about that the other day, too, by the way. But he was just talking about machine guns. And I'm thinking, what does a person need a machine gun anyway? You don't need no tank or machine gun. But the TSA thing, nah. I don't want TSA anywhere. They shouldn't even be in airports. Airports should be handling their own security. I say shut the TSA down. So, I've rambled for 16 minutes here. God bless the USA. God bless the people that are hurt tonight. God bless Jason Aldean and all them that had to live through all that, including Big and Rich and all them other people that was damaged. Big and Rich, I read an article from them. They was right below the scumbum's room. Everybody that was affected, everybody that seen that, everybody that seen this carnage, they're just like they've been on a battlefield. They're going to suffer from this. Their brains are going to suffer from it. My brain's going to suffer from it. Because I've told you, I'm through with concerts. Because we are not living in a sane world anymore. It's been mad for a while, but we're in the days of Noah. We're just like the days of Noah. When God flooded the world. But he ain't going to flood it this time. And with all this stuff with Korea, you gotta wonder. He said next time he'd take it out with fire. Well, guess what? Guess what that little tinpot dictator wants to do? He wants to blow this world up. So you might better get on your knees and repent and pray to God to forgive your soul. Because our world is in the days of Noah. And you can laugh at me. Go ahead and call me crazy, religious. You can even call me John the Baptist and I'm screaming in the woods or whatever. Blah, blah, blah. Yes, I love that Jesus Freak song. It's one of my favorite songs. But you better thank God for every day you got right now because we are going into holy hell here. holy hell is what you're going to see. A world of madness. A real world of madness. The Charles Manson type world of madness. And that's what Antifa wants to do. They want to bring to light the prophecies of that madman Charles Manson in the 1960s. And that's what we're going into. That's what that day marked. And this is the 100th anniversary of the Bolshevik, the Russian communist rise of the communism. This is the very month, October, the 100th year. I started podcasting about that in April. About this being the 100th year of that revolution. This world's fixing to see a whole lot of evil. And it ain't just America, sadly. Look at poor Europe. How long will Slovakia and Hungary and Romania and all them be safe before they're forced to take them animals that wants to destroy Europe? They're already threatening Hungary a couple months ago. I haven't been keeping up with that lately. Threatening them with fines and all this other stuff and sending UN troops and everything else. EU or UN, I don't remember which one it is. It's all the same. It's the UN's the blanket of all the nations, and the EU is the United States version of the Europe, but it's not really like the United States. They don't have the same protections and constitution that we do. Especially where the right to bear arms is concerned, and how long before we have that? Because yes, you're right. Arms would have not helped you with this. I don't even think a handgun would probably reach where he was at. But there's other situations. You can be out in a store somewhere, and you'd be behind the shooter, and you could shoot him that way. Now, if they had that old body armor on, like that Batman shooter, and that thing wasn't as lone wolf as they tried to make that sound, neither. He was an MK Ultra kid. I mean, just look back on his history. He was like the MK Ultra children. So that wasn't what people made it out to be. But even if this man intended to do the damage that he did, but we're heading into a world of madness, the days of Noah, as it was in the days of Noah. You've even got the appearances of the aliens, which we've been having since 1940s, since Roswell. Well, that's a part of it. The fallen ones. The return of the fallen angels. You got the genetic manipulation. You got the merging with machines. You got the sex bots. You got the all the stuff. As the days, and I don't know if they had that back then, but it was an evil world. But you did have the genetic manipulation. That's all in the Book of Enoch. So, 22 minutes here, and I'm going to close. You can call me crazy if you want to. You can say, oh, he's just a crazy, reclusive person. I just don't like crowds. I never did. When I went to the classroom, I usually went to the back of the room unless I was forced to. There's some teachers who wouldn't let you do that. But if I could get by with it, I went to the back of the room. That's just the way I am. That's the way I like things. But now, I'm going to be forced to stay away from something that I really, really enjoyed. I've got videos of where I tape shows. Today I don't tape them like I used to, because I don't feel like holding it. And I usually use a phone anyway. There were some Hinder shows I taped of entire shows. And Guns N' Roses, when I seen them a few times, with the exception of the last one, which Slash was at, because I had some head stuck in my way all night. I taped what I could. But my days of going to see people are over. And I'm glad I got to see all the bands that I got to see. My very first show was a country show by the name of Ricky Lynn Gregg. He was my first artist I ever seen. He was friends with Dimebag Darrell, by the way. My second person to see was Billy Ray Cyrus, and I seen him again this summer, on my birthday of all days. And I seen Bon Jovi earlier this year. He's a leftist liberal, too. He's a Democrat. He's a radical Democrat. I kind of didn't want to go see him because of that, but I decided, hey, I grew up listening to Bon Jovi. I mean, I was into Bon Jovi. New Jersey was my album. If I ever liked an album from Bon Jovi, it was New Jersey. That first song, Lay Your Hands on Me, Living in Sin, Born to Be My Baby. I loved those songs. There was even one on there called Stick to Your Guns. I liked it. That other one, the one about the birthday, I can't think of what it was called. I loved it, where it says the line about, to think I missed your birthday, baby, or what. I'll be there for you. That's it. I'll be there for you. Pearl Jam, I used to love their music, but I didn't go see them. I seen Foo Fighters several times. He wore me out. I didn't even stop going to see him over political issues. It was the two times, one time I seen him, he got sick. And the second time I seen him, he just drawled those songs out. Each song was a big encore. And I felt wore out. It wore me out, and I said, well, I've seen enough of Foo Fighters, but I still love him. I still loved his music. I don't like his politics. I don't like all these people's politics. Motley Crue, I grew up on Motley Crue and Guns N' Roses and Skid Row. Oh, I just seen Skid Row this April. I didn't even want to go to that because I just don't want to go to shows anymore. But I went. I made myself go see Skid Row. I don't care if they don't got Sebastian Bach. I seen Sebastian Bach too. He was good. He was good on his own. But I still love Skid Row. I still love Guns N' Roses. I seen Poison. He was good. His show was good. I seen Motley Crue several times. Seen Hinder open up for him one time. Big fan of Hinder. Seen Hinder lots of times. Met him on the very area where the Orlando scumbung shooter shot. We went down there and that club was in that area. Wasn't the same club, but it was another club, and it was in that area. I actually met him that night. That was right before Austin left them. So, I've had a lot of concert memories, and thank God, because it all started my obsession with music, and I've had it all my life, because I'd play my mother's record collection. But my obsession with being the singer started with Live at the Ritz, Guns N' Roses. But it's over. When the music's over. Just like the Doors sung, it's over for me. Cause I can't anymore. Seeing that I can't. No more plans for me. So I'm gonna close. You say you've got to stand for something or you'll fall for anything. You've got to be your own man, not a puppet on the string. Never cross. Thank you for listening to the APS show on rockandroll100fm.com. The Duck Quack 2017 All Rights Reserved.